Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team. Today, we're going to be looking at how PCB Exchange can be used to view and analyze IDX files in NX. The PCB Exchange application works within NX to provide tools to set printed circuit board features and exchange data with ECAD systems. In this video, we're going to specifically look at what settings are necessary to open IDX files. IDX files are a type of file format that allows electrical and mechanical designers to collaborate on PCB designs. Once we've selected the proper settings, we'll go ahead and load in a file to see the value PCB Exchange provides. Let's go ahead and get started. To begin, we must first select the PCB Exchange application from the Design group within the Application tab. This will provide us with the most important tools and commands for completing PCB tasks. After that, we next need to make sure we have the right settings selected. If we open PCB Exchange Preferences, the two areas we will want to look are IDX Collaboration and Other Entities. To ensure proper functionality in the IDX Collaboration tab, it's important to set the collaboration directory to the correct file folder. Once that's done, we will next navigate to the Other Entities tab. Here, we must make sure to check Traces, Pads, solder masks, paste masks, and generic shapes to ensure they are imported as defined in the ECAD file. Additionally, setting all of these options to load as bodies will help to provide the best visual experience. With our preferences now set, we can now read our first file. After selecting the Read PCB command, we need to choose our baseline file. We should also select the Only Use Existing Components checkbox to ensure the assembly consists of components for which a detailed component NX part file already exists. When we select OK, our assembly will load in, with an information window providing component history. One of the most important benefits of PCB Exchange is the value the PCB Design Navigator provides. Here, we can track all of the components within our assembly, as well as all hole details. Selecting a component or hole will highlight the respective part in the display window. This is also a great place to keep track of component details such as part numbers, owner, and offset distances. If at any time we want to view which components are similar, we can reference the assembly navigator, which will contain the complete list of imported parts. Selecting an item in the assembly navigator will highlight each item in both the display window and the PCB navigator. One other capability that PCB Exchange provides is the option to read design layers. If we select the Read Design Layers tool, we can choose another IDX file to import our ECAD layers, nets, and pad stacks. When we select OK, we can see the silkscreen file has now been included, and we are now able to view the traces associated with our printed circuit board. If we want to view the layers of our PCB that we just added in, we can edit the Edit Object Display for our board. Increasing the translucency will allow us to view the internal layers. In conclusion, in this video, we've reviewed the basics of getting started with PCB Exchange in NX. We began by investigating PCB preferences to ensure we had the proper settings selected. After that, we used the Read PCB command to open our IDX file. And finally, we wrapped up by using the Read Design Layers command to add traces and layers to our circuit board. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.